Hello, my fellow yogis. Welcome back to Simple Holistic Yoga. I hope you're all doing well and staying safe in this COVID-19 pandemic situation that's surrounding all of us. Today, I have another Vinyasa flow prepared for us. Hopefully something that's going to help us draw our attention and focus more inwards. And maybe we will come out of this practice feeling a little more calmer, and centered. So let's just get started with it. Today we're gonna start in child's pose. So for that, you just wanna get on your knees and maybe shuffle your knees a little bit wide, maybe even as wide as the mat if that's comfortable for you. And then you wanna bring your feet a little bit closer, and then you just wanna sit back down on your feet. Now from here, you're gonna keep your hands out in front of you, walk your hands forward, and then release your torso onto the mat. Now this may not be possible for a lot of us, and if it isn't working comfortably for you, then you can always place a pillow or two in front of you, a bolster if you have one, and then just release yourself on the support of that bolster. I just wanna make sure that you're all comfortable wherever you're at, because we're just gonna be here for a few breaths, and the idea is to allow your mind to calm down and not be worried with the discomfort of any position. So whatever works for you is where you're going to go. And if that means that just sitting down is more comfortable for you with your legs straight out, that's totally fine. Just be where you're at, just be comfortable. So for the rest of us, we're just gonna walk our hands out in front of us and then release our torso down onto the mat. And then from here, you just want to allow your body to sink into the mat. And just start to take deep breaths in and out. With each outflow of breath, I want you to try and feel as if your body is becoming heavier and heavier, and that you're sinking deeper and deeper into your pose. You want to allow all the muscles in your body to relax. And just continue with your breathing. With each in-breath, you want to focus on the breath widening your back. So you want to feel the breath fill your upper back, moving down to your lower back, and then resting at the base of your spine. And with each exhalation, you want to sink in deeper and start to feel as if each outflow of breath that rides up from the base of your spine and releases your body, that you're also releasing any negative thoughts, any negative energy, or maybe even instilling a feeling of letting go. And then from here, this quiet time, the space that you've carved out for yourself, you may even want to set an intention for yourself or for someone else, for a loved one or even a complete stranger, anyone that you want to release today's positive energies out to. And then from here, you will slowly let your breath return to its normal pace of breathing. And just bringing the awareness back into your body. We're slowly going to walk our hands back towards us and close to our body. Now from here, we're just gonna come back onto our sit bones and extend our legs out in front of us. So I'm gonna face everybody now. You just wanna extend your legs out in front of you. You wanna keep your feet flexed, your toes pointing towards you. And then I just want you to round and curl your spine into this pose.
So you're just gonna let your hands fall wherever they comfortably do, and then you're just gonna allow your body to melt into this. So just round your spine, round your neck, and just release any tension in your body. And then we're gonna slowly rise up from this.
And from here, we're gonna bring our legs in a cross-leg position. And we're just gonna warm up the spine a little more. So you're gonna interlace your fingers in front of you, flip your palms away from you and extend your arms out. And as you inhale, you're gonna lift your arms up, reaching up towards the ceiling, but you wanna be mindful. You wanna keep your shoulders away from you. Maybe even your gaze looks up. And then as you exhale, you're gonna round and curl your spine as you bring the hands to face the front of the room. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, round and curl. Inhaling one more time. Deep breath in. And exhale and round and curl. And now you're gonna release your hands besides you. Now you're gonna draw your hands back, interlace your fingers, and then with your right hand, you're gonna tuck your left hand and bring it to the right. Now from here, you wanna keep tugging at your left hand as if you're trying to pull it to the right, and this is gonna give you a nice stretch in your left shoulder. Now if you wanna take the stretch in your right shoulder, you're gonna start to push your right elbow towards the back of the room. Just continuing with your breaths while you do this. Anyway, you wanna tilt your head to the left if you wanna take this on the right side of your neck. And then we're gonna release. We're gonna inhale our arms up, fingertips reach up. Exhale, our hands back down. Once again, interlacing our hands behind us. This time, we are going to tug at the right hand, pulling it to the left side of our body. And this will give you your stretch in the right shoulder. Now, you're either gonna stay here, or if you wanna intensify your stretch a little bit, you're gonna push that left elbow to point towards the back of the room. And taking this into your neck, only if it is comfortable and available to you, you're gonna start to tilt your neck to the right. Deep breaths flowing in and out of your body. And then from there, we're gonna slowly release and just do a few shoulder rolls. So you're just gonna do a few shoulder rolls back and a few shoulder rolls front. And from here, we're gonna meet on our hands and knees. So, when you're here, you just wanna make sure that your wrist is just underneath your shoulder and that your knees are just underneath your hips. And then we'll just do a few cat and cows. As you inhale, you're gonna lift your heart, lift your spine, lift your gaze. Exhale, as you round and curl, release your head and your neck. Inhale. Heart and chest lift. Exhale, round and curl. One more time, inhale. And exhale. And then from here, coming back to neutral, once again, we're gonna move into child's pose. So you're gonna spread your legs as wide as the mat. You already know where we're going with this, and just let your body melt into the pose. And now bringing yourself back to your hands and knees, we're going to move into puppy pose. So when you do your puppy pose, you want to make an effort to keep your hips just above your knees. But you're gonna walk your hands out forward and you're going to try to release your torso onto the mat only as far as it goes. Again, it's completely fine to use the support of a pillow or a bolster or even your blocks. And so you're just gonna release your body down onto the mat
Again, you want to try to keep your hips above your knees the best as you can. I know it's hard to do that without a mirror, but you just want to sort of gaze and try your best. And then once you're releasing your torso as low as it goes, you want to reach the crown of your head towards the mat. Or a bolster if that's what you're using from support. Now from here, you're going to keep your elbows planted on the mat, but you're going to bend at the elbows and bring your hands in prayers and release your hands at the base of your skull. Now from here, you're going to draw your elbows close towards one another. Now remember, you know, this is just an action in your body. You're not literally moving your elbows, but it's the action of engaging your upper arms as if you're drawing those elbows towards one another and engaging your upper arms. Breathing into the space in your upper body. And from there, we're going to release our hands back down. And you're going to slowly walk yourselves back up into a neutral tabletop. Tuck your toes under and lift your hips up, downward facing dog. So take a moment here, pedal out your legs if that's what feels good. Maybe even swing your hips from side to side if that feels good. Just finding your comfort zone in your downward facing dog. And then from here, looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step, or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale and fold. Inhaling halfway up, and exhale and fold and release the crown of your head towards the mat. Inhaling one more time. Exhale and fold. You're gonna bend your knees and slowly curl your spine up to standing. One more time. Inhaling, reaching up, growing tall. Exhale and folding in. Inhaling halfway up. Exhale and release. Inhaling one more time. Halfway up. Exhale and release. And then bend your knees and slowly curl your spine up to standing. Arms reach up. This time even longer than you did the first time around. And exhale and folding forward. Inhale. Half lift, exhale and step back into plank. Just trying to feel your plank, feeling the energy within you, the strength within you. Just trying to draw your lower belly in, keeping those heels pushing back towards the back of the room, making a nice smiley face with your collarbones. And then from here, we're going to release knees, chest and chin. Inhale. Exhale and move back into downward facing dog. Once again, feeling your dog, pedaling out your legs. And then from here, looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step, or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, rising all the way up. And exhale, hands to your heart. Inhaling, reaching up, exhale and folding in. Inhaling halfway up, exhale stepping back into plank and lowering down through your choice of vinyasa, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, baby cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, rising up. And exhale, hands to your heart. Now I want you to bring your big toes to touch. Your heels can be 1 inch apart. And then from here, you're going to bend your knees, sink your hips, and then just lift your arms up to chair pose.
So here, see if you can, you know, sit back a little bit, maybe even lift your toes so that you're not dumping a lot of weight in your knees. You don't want to overarch your neck. You want to maintain the natural curvature of your spine. And then from here, we're going to bring our hands in prayer. And as you inhale, you want to first find length in your spine. And then as you exhale, we're going to twist right. So now when you twist, you want to make sure that your knees are even and that your hips are even. That is to protect your lower back. Deep breaths in and out. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, hands in prayer. Once again, inhaling, finding length in your spine, and exhale and twist left. It's harder to breathe when we're twisting, so it's very important that you just make sure that you're channeling your breath in and out and not letting it get sporadic. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, and you're going to fold over straight legs or bent knees if that feels good. From here, you want to bring your feet hip width apart. And maybe even grab opposite elbows to clasp, and you could ragdoll yourself from side to side. Releasing your hands back down onto the mat, maybe even bringing your feet a little bit closer again. Inhaling halfway up, exhale, fold. One more time, inhale, halfway up. Exhale and fold. Maybe even shake your head from side to side. And then you're going to bend your knees and slowly curl your spine up to standing. From here, you're going to interlace your hands behind you, bringing your feet hip width apart again. Inhale, lift your heart and chest as you draw those interlaced hands towards the floor. Maybe even gaze up, find that back bend. And then exhale and fold. So you want to keep your arms reaching up. You want to keep those upper arms especially reaching up. You want to relax your neck, release the crown of your head towards the mat. And then from here, releasing your hands back down onto the mat, inhaling halfway up, exhaling, step back into plank and lower down. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, baby cobra, or upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in, and let it go. One more time, breathing in, and letting go of any tension, anything that doesn't serve your purpose. This is your moment, your time, and your space. Just let it work for you. From here, looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step, or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, rising up, growing tall. Exhale, hands to your heart. Inhale. And exhale and fold. Always hinging from your hips. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale and step back, downward facing dog. Inhale your right leg up, high to the sky. Maybe even bend your right knee and open up that hip. So you're going to try to have your right knee point up towards the ceiling. But you want to make sure that you're making every effort possible to keep your hips squared and even your arms squared. And if it feels good, you can even make circles with your knee. So this is your practice. This is your calming practice. So you want to do whatever feels good to you. You can modify each pose as it works best for you. And then from here, you're going to step that right foot forward in between your hands. Rising up,
high lunge, crescent lunge, and sink down into your crescent lunge. So you want to make sure that your pelvic floor is lifted, that lower belly is drawn in towards the back body, your thighs are magnetizing towards one another. Deep breaths flowing in and out of your body. And that back foot is engaged. So you want to keep the ball of that back foot pressing onto the mat. And then from here, bringing your hands in prayer, we're going to move into a twist. As you exhale, you're going to twist right. So if this is comfortable for you, you can stay here. If this is a bit much for you, then you can always drop your left knee onto the mat for support. So you're going to find your variation here, your calming variation. If you feel your breath is getting erratic, then it may be a good idea to drop your left knee onto the mat. Otherwise, you can keep your left knee lifted. Inhale, rising up, growing tall. Arms reach up. Exhale, hands frame your foot. And now from here, you're going to start to straighten your right leg. You're still going to stay on the ball of your left leg. If you need to use blocks here for support, go for it. And then you're going to fold over your extended leg. So you want to make an effort to keep both your legs straight here. And if that means you have to use the blocks, that's pretty cool, that's fine. And if you have the blocks, you just want to get them aside, re-bend your right knee, step back into downward facing dog. And then you're going to move through a vinyasa of your choice. Inhale, baby cobra or upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Deep breath in, deep breath out. So your downward facing dog is actually like your, you know, pause. It's like your reset pose. So just allow it to sink into the mat deeper. You know, press into your heels, press into your fingers, your hands. Just let yourself feel heavier and heavier and closer to the earth. From here, looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step, or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, rising up, growing tall. And exhale, folding back down. Inhaling halfway up. Exhale and step back, downward facing dog. From here, your left foot rises high to the sky. And maybe you want to bend your left knee and point that up towards the ceiling. Making circles with your knee if that feels good. Or keeping the knee pointed towards the ceiling and just making circles with your ankle. From here, you're going to look at the space in between your hands. You're going to draw your knee in closer to your chest, and then step that left foot forward in between your hands. High lunge on the left side. Once again, fingertips growing tall, ball of that right foot pressing into the mat, holding you in this pose. Lower belly is drawn in, chest is nice and high. Enjoy the power in the pose. And then from here, hands in prayer, as we move into a twist, inhale, grow tall, exhale, twist left. Find your balance here.
you, and if that means you need to drop your right knee onto the mat, that's completely fine. It's your practice. You're going to modify it and mold it however it works best for you. You want to have one line of energy all the way from the heel of your right foot to the crown of your head. And then from here, inhaling back up, high lunge. Exhale, releasing your hands back down onto the mat. This time you're going to straighten the left leg. Again, placing blocks for support if that's what you need. That's what you need to bring the earth closer to you. That's completely fine. And then once you're comfortable, you're just going to fold over your left leg. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. And from here, you're going to re-bend the left leg and then step back, downward facing dog. Look at the space in between your hands. You're going to walk, step, or jump forward and fold forward. Inhale, rising up, growing tall. Exhale, and folding in. Inhaling halfway up. Exhale and release. Inhale, bend your knees, and slowly curl your spine up to standing. Now from here, we're going to do a little bit of a side bend, but I'm going to turn my back so that you can see me better, just because this sounds tricky. It's not tricky, it just sounds off, but when you do it, you'll know what I mean. So from here, you want to stand with your feet about hip width apart, and then you want to inhale your arms up, and then you're going to grab your left wrist with your right hand. And then you're going to bend over to the right. Now, this is the part where you kind of need to pay attention a little bit. You want to shift your weight into your left foot. So you're going to shift all your weight into your left foot. And then you're going to lift your right leg off of the mat. And release. And release your hands back down. We'll do that on the other side. Inhaling, reaching up. And then you're going to grab your right wrist this time with your left hand. You're going to bend over to the left, shift all your weight in your right foot, and then lift the left leg off of the mat. And release. And I'm just going to turn back around. I had to turn around because it's easier to follow along on the same side, so that's why. Anyway, back to the tops of our mat, hands in prayer, inhaling, reaching up, growing tall, exhale and fold. Inhale halfway up, exhale and fold again. Inhaling, rising up. And exhale, hands to your heart. Okay, so from here, we're going to move back into chair pose. So you want to bend your knees, sink your hips, and lift your arms up into chair pose. And we're going to move into chair pose twist. You want to bring your hands in prayer. Inhale, grow nice and long with your spine. Exhale and twist right. Now from here, we're going to transition into what we did before, which is the revolved side angle pose, which means that your right leg is going to stay where it is and the left leg is going to move back. Now if that means that you need to shift your left leg back in baby steps, that's completely fine. Or you can shift your left leg back in one whole step. Now to make sure that you're maintaining your balance, the first step is you want to ground on firmly through your right foot, because that's what's going to keep you here and keep you balanced. Then you're going to turn your gaze to look down towards your right foot. And then once you're strong and secure, then you're going to step your left foot back. Sink into the pose,
and then you can turn your head right once again. There you are, revolve side angle. Inhale, arms reach up, high lunge. Exhale, hands free, your foot, step back. Downward facing dog. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. So you're drinking a lot of breath here. From here, looking at the space in between your hands, you're going to walk, step, or jump forward. And fold forward. Inhale, rising up, growing tall. And exhale, hands to your heart. And so from here, we'll do this on the other side now. So you're going to bend your knees, sink your hips, rise up, chair pose. And then from here, bringing your hands in prayer, deep inhalation as you find length in your spine. And then as you exhale, you're going to twist left. So we already know where we're going with this. You're either going to step your right foot back in baby steps or in one step. If you're doing it in one step, very importantly, ground down firmly through your left foot. Shift all your weight in your left foot. Turn your gaze to look towards your left foot. That's going to keep it grounded. That's what's going to help you with your balance. So you're going to turn your gaze to look towards your left foot and then transition your right foot back in one step. Once you're there, you can turn your gaze back to the left. From here, inhaling, rising up. Exhale, hands freeing your foot, step back. Downward facing dog. And then from here, you're gonna lower your knees onto the mat, moving back into your child's pose. Again, you're drinking a lot of breath here right now. I want you to notice if your mind has become any more calm than it was at the beginning of this practice. Were the challenges able to draw your attention and focus inward? You just continue with your breaths and allow yourself to sink into your child's pose for however long you want, and then you can transition onto Shavasana.
That was it for today's practice. Thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you back again for some more.